Mario Strikers is the newest entry to the Mario franchise, and honestly, it is amazing. It is a little overwhelming at first, so here is a beginner's guide for you. What's up, guys? Welcome to the channel. My name is Dusty, one half of Our Idiot Gaming, and the very first tip I have for you guys is something I wish I knew when I first started, and that is the difference between auto and manual in Mario Strikers. So the first time you go into a game, especially if you just dove right in and skip the tutorial, you'll notice there is an option to choose between auto and manual. Unfortunately, the game really doesn't say much more about this. It just kind of gives you the option. So the difference is that if you pick automatic, whenever you pass the ball to someone, you will automatically switch to that character that you pass to. If you have it on manual, you will have to manually switch to that character. And obviously, this is more of a preference thing, so you pick whichever one you like better, play around with the auto and manual, see which one really fits your playstyle. As for me, I pretty much just leave it on auto at all times because I like being in control of the ball at all times. If you're playing with, say, 2 to 3 people on the same team, maybe it'll be easier for you guys to pick manual. That way, there's no confusion. But honestly, even whenever my wife, Ashley, and I played with our nephew, we all pretty much just kept it on auto and really didn't have any issues. Tip number two I have for you guys is to do the tutorial. And I know, do the tutorial, Dusty. Are you kidding me? But honestly, it helps so much. It lays a great foundation of what to do in the game, how to master your skills, and it even goes in depth to some advanced skills. And while I'm at it, don't feel like that if you went through the tutorial once, you don't ever need to do it again, because you can always keep coming back to the tutorial and learning more and mastering your skills even more, because odds are you're going to forget some stuff in the hecticness that is this game. And especially whenever you play online, you'll probably forget some stuff that you learned in the tutorial, so go back and master your skills in tutorial mode. And even if you don't want to do the tutorial, be sure to complete the training match, because it gives you an automatic 800 coins if you win, and that is a ton of coins. Tip number three for you guys is to press B to get the ball from Boom Boom. Whenever we first started playing this game, I was like, okay, when is he going to pass the ball? Why does he just pass it to somebody random? This is weird. Then I figured out you could press B and he passes it to you whenever he is holding it at your goal. You can use this to your advantage to get away from your opponents, have him throw it to you in open space, or honestly just walk right up to him, have him throw it to you right in front of him, and you really just have avoided all of your opponents. This is especially useful if you're having trouble getting the ball intercepted from inbounding. I promise this will help you a ton. And speaking of Boom Boom, our tip number four is all about Boom Boom. Pay attention to where he is at all times. There are times when he will step super far away from the goal, especially when the ball is at the halfway line, and honestly, use this to your advantage. You can use this to knock in some side shots behind him. Also, if he's on the right side of the goal, be sure to aim your shot on the left side and vice versa. This will make it a lot harder for him to block and allow you to make it in the goal much easier. And while we're on the topic, if you notice that you've shot at Boom Boom with a charge shot and missed, be sure to have a character up close to immediately shoot afterwards, as he obviously can't defend when he's knocked out. This is a great way to get easy goals. And speaking of getting easy goals, if the ball is knocked into the air off the crossbar or off of Boom Boom, this is another way to get super easy goals. After you shoot the ball either with a charge shot or your teammate shoots it, you can actually get under the area it shows when the ball either bounces off Boom Boom or off the crossbar and get another shot off by hitting A again. A lot of times your character will jump up in midair and shoot another shot and it'll look super awesome. And if Boom Boom is out of position, this is a great way to score it super, super, super easy. Honestly, I found myself doing this a lot the more I played the game, and it not only looks super cool, but it is super easy to get goals this way. Tip number six is one that I really, really honestly need to practice on, and that is learning how to tackle. There's a difference in tackling and learning how to tackle and when to tackle. Tackling is honestly my favorite thing to do in the game. Me, my wife Ashley, and our nephew were playing this game recently, as I said, and I'm telling you, we literally tackled everyone. It was absolute pure chaos, and we had such a great time doing it. But honestly, as much as I love tackling in this game, I found it to be a fault at times. If you miss a tackle because the enemy dodges it, they will get a boost. If you miss a tackle in general, whether they dodge it or not, the character that tried to tackle will be down and out for a little bit. If you tackle an opponent who doesn't have the ball, it also gives the enemy item boxes. So while we were playing, we were like, why does our opponents have so many item boxes? We have like none. And it's because we were going around just spam tackling everyone. All of these CPUs were getting obliterated into the electric fence, and they were getting a bunch of item boxes all in the meantime. Obviously, sometimes it is good to even tackle players that don't even have the ball if they're in a vital scoring position or if they're about to receive a pass. And also, you don't have to charge tackle every single time. at me, because honestly, I'm really bad about doing that every time. If you have a high strength character, sometimes it's best to just quick tackle them than to risk missing them. Also, on that topic, be mindful not just to quick tackle anyone. Because if you try to quick tackle like Bowser with a weak noodle like Toad, it's gonna be embarrassing. Another super vital thing that I totally forgot after the tutorial was remembering to sprint. This tip is super, super important. You can sprint by holding ZR, and this obviously helps you break away from opponents, as well as get a ball that's on the loose, or get the hyper strike or before anyone else, or an item before anyone else. Not to mention, you get a huge boost for dodging attacks, so definitely remember to dodge attacks by clicking R. Our next tip is don't forget to use the special items, or remember that you have special items, and honestly use them before your hopper strikes. For some reason, one of the absolute hardest things for me to remember in this game is that I have special items. I literally always forget. These items can come in so handy though. So even though you're trying to score goals and play defense and just go through the chaos that is this game, definitely remember to pick up some items and use them. Also, one of the best times to use these items is right before a hopper strike. So if you have a hopper strike and there's a bunch of enemies around you, you can clear them out by using items and then boom, hopper strike. If you have the superstar, you're literally untouchable and it's a free hopper strike. You can also use them while you're hopper striking, even though it is more challenging. And additionally, if you're on defense, you can use these items to knock them down before they hopper strike to prevent them. And you can obviously also use tackle to prevent them from hopper striking as well. Our next tip is to try and to pass to your teammates that have higher technique abilities when you do have a hopper strike. This will save you in a lot of situations. While you're playing the game, be sure to know which players on your teams do have a higher technique skill. This will help get you a bigger area so you can get a perfect hopper strike more than if you were just using some random character that had terrible technique. Not that you can't get perfect hopper strikes with other characters, but it's definitely a lot easier with players that have higher technique. And also, speaking of hopper strike, my next tip is to actually stay super close to the goal after the hopper strike. The reason I say that is because this will help you get some goals. After you perform a hyper strike, be sure to have some teammates near the goal. Also, while Boom Boom is attempting to block the hyper strike, assuming it's not perfect, knock down every player you can. This will allow you to be able to get the ball back. And if Boom Boom is knocked down, you'll be able to get a quick goal in because he won't be able to defend it. So definitely keep some players close to the goal after that hyper strike. And don't think just because your hyper strike doesn't connect that your chance of scoring is over. More often than not, if you immediately shoot after a hyper strike, you will score. And my very last tip is to just keep playing the game. The more you play this game, the better you will become, just like anything else. You're not going to start this game out more than likely absolutely perfect at the game. It's going to take some time, and the more repetition you have in this game, the better you will get. As my wife and my nephew and I played this game, we were like screaming at the TV. There were times we had last second shots and we were up off the couch jumping around, and it was just so fun. So have fun with this game, play it, and you will get better. Because even at the first of this game, the more we played, we were like, man, we're getting a little better at this game. This is so fun. And that is my beginner's guide for you guys. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you like this video, be sure to hit the like button. Also subscribe and turn on the bell so you don't miss a video. If you have any other tips at all, feel free to drop them in the comment section below. I would love to read them. I'm sure people in the comments would also love to read them, as we're all trying to get better at this game. This is one half of Our Radiant Gaming signing off. Everyone have an awesome day, and God bless.